You are listening to a Clarkesworld Magazine podcast with your host and narrator, Kate Baker. Greetings, Clarkesworld citizens, and welcome to the last story for the month of August, issue 215. How have you enjoyed all these stories thus far for this month? Because guess what? Your support means that we can bring you another month of amazing audio. So thank you to those of you who keep coming back, who keep supporting the magazine through a subscription, through support via Patreon. You guys are amazing. And for those of you who haven't yet been able to give monetarily, please consider doing so. Please become a part of this magazine. Help us to bring you all of this really cool stuff each and every month. And together, we can continue supplying all this wonderful short fiction. So our last story for the month of August is titled Three Circuits of the Monoceros Ring, and is by Marisca Pichette. Marisca Pichette is a queer author based in Massachusetts on Pecumtuk and Abenaki land. Her work has appeared in Strange Horizons, Vestarian, the magazine of fantasy and science fiction, Fantasy Magazine, Nightmare Magazine, and others. She is the flash winner of the 2022 Furriction Spring Literary Contest and has been nominated for the Bram Stoker, Pushcart, Best of the Net, Elgin, Utopia, Riesling, and Dwarf Store Awards. Her Bram Stoker and Elgin Award nominated poetry collection, Rivers in Your Skin, Sirens in Your Hair, is out now from Android Press. So my dear listener, I hope you can sit back, relax, and let me tell you a story. Intercepted file number 92, partially corrupted between the orbits of Saturn and Jupiter. Transcribed recipes, mostly savory in nature. Localized ingredients indicate regional origin in Europe. Dear Neon, I tried my hand at your Mame's tart recipe this morning. I was able to replicate most of the ingredients, but of course I had to substitute for boysenberry and cardamom. I think it turned out okay. I won't be sure until it's finished setting up in my tiny fridge. Did you get that live stream of the solar flare? Fucking gorgeous and a little terrifying. I guess that's the difference between a yellow dwarf and a red giant. Chalk tried to capture it in watercolor. Did he send you a picture? 1504 LYA Pastel. Intercepted file number 103. Intact image of a magnified gas giant. No further information. Dear Chalk, wow, your rendering of the outer Milky Way is incredible. I'm glad those glittery paints are working out. You know, the instant I saw them, I thought of you. Things are pretty quiet out here. The nearest asteroid is miles away, and so I'm spending lots of time stargazing while the analytics do their work. Math in the evenings, not as elegant as painting. A few days back, I picked up another rubbish capsule. Cleaning up the galaxy is slow work, but occasionally we come across something interesting. Once the trash in the capsule had been rendered, I had it reprocessed into paper. I'm working on a galaxy of my own now. Origami stars and papier-mâché planets suspended from the mess hall ceiling. Perks of being the only one aboard, I guess. I get to decorate however I please. Got a letter from Pastel last night. Shorter than usual. 2856LYA. Neon. Intercepted file number 134, incomplete recording of someone singing. Voice unknown, masculine, in timbre. Lyrics in French. Dear Pastel, I wish I could taste that flan you made. If only sugar could be coated and sent across space. With ready access to your cooking, the months would fly by in decadence. And I'd soon be too big to fit in my EMU. Here's the latest. Andromeda, as viewed from the east. I set the screen magnification to 4,000. But do me a favor and pretend that's what I see when I look out the viewport, all glitter and majesty. The reality is more boring, of course, just a grainy white smudge on the horizon. I know, there's no horizon out here. But even after almost a year, I can't fully divorce myself from terrestrial comparison. Winters in Alaska were a lot like this, enveloping night, persistent cold, and the wide, wide sky. 28990LYA. Chalk. Intercepted file number 185, unbroken code. When executed, it created a map of the stars in the local group. Lines had been drawn between them, creating constellations in no existing records. Researchers identified a lily, a crane, and an orca. Dear Chalk, I'd send you recipes if I trusted you to make them, right? Try this instead. Ask your processor for 2 small cakes, pound cake or vanilla is best. Then ask for a cup of sweet cream and put it in a bottle. Shake it for at least 2 minutes until it thickens enough to spread. Use it to stick the 2 cakes together and then ask for your favorite fruit to put on top. I also like to add honey. Tell me when you try this if it ends up tasting like home. 39700LYA Pastel. Intercepted file number 201 captured in the asteroid belt. A list of names and dates. Possibly the birth and death dates of pets or similar short-lived creatures. Dear Pastel, I'm enclosing a few more receipts with this letter. I've attempted the simpler ones, but I know better than to try the souffle. Were my meme still alive, she'd gladly trade her grandson for you. She always labored under the misguided belief that my sexuality presaged culinary wonders. In my case, fruity only extended so far as cute, patterned shirts, not elaborate desserts, though I'll never turn down the opportunity to taste them. If our paths cross in a month, a year, you'd better have that table set in waiting. 3012LYA Neon. Intercepted file number 233, irretrievably damaged. Dear Neon, I'm a big fan of Uranus, but you knew that already. Who knew math geeks could make art? In all seriousness, the work you're putting into that sculpture is impressive. I've always tried to capture the beauty of the cosmos, but you harness the reality. It sounds frankly exhausting to carefully measure and ratio your model, coloring every piece with an eye toward faithful reproduction. But at the same time, the pictures you sent are magical. I passed Pluto nearly a year ago, and my memories of it are dim at best. I didn't even think it worth painting. But your Pluto, tiny as it is, a fleck on your fingernail, poised carefully for the photo, took my breath away. Tell me now. Where will you find space to build the sun? 47456LYA Chalk. Intercepted file number 287 on the edge of the solar system. A single step in origami instructions. While the final shape is unknown, it begins with the frog base. Dear Chalk, I'm glad the cakes worked out. I'm working on a list of simple recipes like that. Desserts not even you can fuck up. Did you see Neon Saturn? That's my favorite. It's hard to believe he made it out of paper. It looks just as heavy, just as dense as the real thing. I circled past Saturn last month, collected a few more samples for the research team. Next week, I'll be sending them back home in probes before the distance is too great. When I look out the window, I can no longer tell which spot is Earth. 38760LYA Pastel. Intercepted file number 303, passing Venus. Crash coordinates for a research probe deployed to Earth from the outer solar system, set to land in the Pacific. Dear Pastel, our latest haul included ashes mixed with melted plastic. As I was tumbling them, misshapen fillings clattered into the exclusion tray. They're not the first human remains I've turned up on my journey. Strange finding things like that. On the one hand, it's a reminder that I'm not the only one out here. On the other, it's a sign the nearest soul has fled, disappearing into the long dark. I could use one of those treats tonight, my distant love. 4585LYA Neon. Intercepted file number 314. Almost unreadable. A few words at the end indicate a communication between research ships. Never delivered. Dear Pastel, how long are my messages taking to reach you? I'm nearing the edge of the galaxy now. The last letter I received from Neon was dated a week old. His photos came out pixelated. I worry what might happen when I cross at last into open space. Looking behind, I'm starting to see the hazy shape of the Milky Way. It's always been there, of course, but now that I'm almost outside of it, well, I tried to capture the experience in paint. Let me know if the attached file opens for you. I had to compress it even smaller to cover the vast distance. You might be heading in the same direction, but I feel like the hare sprinting ahead. If only I could stop for a rest, wake up to find a tortoise at my side. 43800LYA Chalk. Dear Neon, Tonight I'm making a pen au chocolat. Join me? Your meme taught us this one together, standing shoulder to shoulder in her sunny kitchen. Yours might fall a little flat, but they'll taste just as delicious. Chalk was already launched when we sat in the garden and tasted our pastries over cappuccino. I remember his first letter back, a swirling blue globe, suspended in the dark. The glitter paints you gave him articulated the atmosphere, shimmering and seemingly alive. I printed the photo and hung it up in my office, a reminder of who we are, where we are. I still have that photo. It hangs over my cot. I hope in a year, a decade, I get to see Chalk's painted world again. The real thing never quite lived up to his art. 741-2LYA. Pastel. Dear Chalk, your last letter took 10 days to reach me, or 10 nights. If I look out the window, the sun grows more distant from me. For you, I know it's just another star now. Here's a picture of my completed solar system. Yes, I ended up just building half of a sun, wedged against the wall. Even with all I've scrounged and recycled, I couldn't spare the filling to make it stable as a sphere. I hope this is a reminder for you that no matter how far away you fly, the light's still on, awaiting your return. You haven't sent a painting in a while. What are you working on? 52614LYA. Neon. Dear Neon, I'm out now. Your file got corrupted. It might not work, but could you try sending a picture of your face? 63480LYA. Chalk. Dear Chalk, I've included front and side views since I know how much you like my jaw. Oh, and I hope the third photo loads is a spicier one. Whenever you get this, I want you to try recipe number 18 for me. 52300LYA, pastel. Dear Chalk, sending over five pics. One's a bit older. You should recognize it if it arrives intact. It's from your launch day. You in uniform looking beautiful with me in pastel in front of the conservatory. My hair is a mess and I've got somebody's lipstick on my shirt. Pastels, maybe? On Monday, it'll be 18 months since you left, a year since Pastel's launch, and just 6 months since mine. I salvaged some metal and made a ring. If you got anything to spare, will you make one too? 70222LYA, Neon. Dear Neon, two of the files worked, though we lost Pastel in the group photo. You can see their hand around my waist, and the rest is static. Thank you. I missed your smile. It's hard to believe we were ever that young, and yet it hasn't even been 2 years. I took an old washer and filed it down over a few days. It fits my ring finger. 81500LYA. Chalk. Dear Neon, you know me. I have to be a little extra. I'm attaching a photo of my ring using the tines of a fork to create a triple braided design. You, me, Chalk. I made it a bit tight, so I'm not sure I'll be able to get it off. Not that I want to. I sent him a picture as well. I should have a little more luck getting the file to him uncorrupted. Past Pluto, by the way. No offense, but your model didn't do it justice. 12875LYA. Pastel. Dear Pastel and Chalk, I'm sending this message to both of you, but I know you'll get it at different times. Consider this my wedding vow. 5 years we've known each other. 5 years. We'll sail the stars. Wherever we end up when our mission's complete, whether it be a planet or a galaxy apart, I vow to find you. I vow to board the first and fastest ship to you. I vow to keep in contact as long as my letters continue to reach their destinations. I vow to keep writing even if my words get lost in the space between us. I vow to love you both as long as I live. 14555/82788, light years away. Neon. Dear Neon and Chalk, the more I catch up with one of you, the more I leave the other behind. I hope you receive this letter and my vows within. Nothing I make will ever be sweeter than your touch. No image can compare to your face. Let our rings remind us that every journey is cyclical, every beginning within sight of its end. If this is a race, there's no shame in coming last. With this love, I'm not afraid of the emptiness outside. I know I'm not truly alone. I vow to love you both as long as I live. 17213/6200 light years away. Pastel. Dear Neon and Pastel, I received your vows out of order. Now I have them side by side, printed and tacked to the wall. I've painted the edges with stars. You talk about races and destinations, but I'm going to beat you both. When my mission finishes in 3 years, I'll be the one to board a ship to take me to Pastel's destination. I'll wait as long as it takes, and when they land, we'll book another journey, speeding over the last 6 months until we reach Neon's end. And when he disembarks, there will be no more ships, no more waiting, no more dark. Here is my vow, spoken between galaxies, even now creeping closer to one another, drawn by the inexorable desire in their hearts. When I close my eyes, I see you. When I hold myself, I feel you. When I paint you. There's no beauty greater than the two souls I pledge myself to now. Over light years of distance, I love you. I love you. My ship sails on, accelerating into the unknown. I don't know where I'll end up. I do know with whom. I vow to love you both as long as I live. 94630/71800 light years away. Chalk. Intercepted file, number 333. Miraculously uncorrupted in the third layer of the Monoceros Ring, on the outskirts of the Milky Way. A photo of three people in uniform on an unknown exoplanet with a very colored horizon. They hold hands, looking not at the camera, but at each other. Each wears a mismatched homemade ring. What are your thoughts on the story? You can send an email. I'm kate@clarkesworldmagazine.com, and that is Clark with an E. Thank you again for joining us for these August stories. With your support and your help, we make it to September. And I do hope you'll come back and listen, should you so choose. Until then, my dear listener, I bid you a very fond and hopefully very temporary farewell.